1905年，外交小尖兵英语种子队选拔活动中区初赛开始。介绍贵宾：外交部公众外交协调会李宪章副执行长，请大家掌声欢迎。公共电视杜怡芬组长。感谢台中市私立新民高级中学杨宝琴校长提供优良比赛场地，以及协助比赛事宜的各位师长同学。接下来为大家介绍今天中区初赛的五位评审：国立台中教育大学英语学系陈宇光教授，静宜大学英国语文学系杨义军教授，东海大学外国语文学系萧继化教授，国立彰化师范大学英语系楚湘君教授，亚洲大学外国语文学系穆马素教授。现在我们就请主办单位之一的外交部公众外交协调会李宪章副执行长上台为我们说几句话。
新民高中的校长还有老师，各位评审委员，还有各位同学、各位老师、各位家长，大家早安，大家好。可不可以再大声一点好吗？我是专程从台北下来的，我等一下回南投老家了，所以也不算专程哦。很高兴今天到新民高中来。我知道新民高中以前办过我们小尖兵的活动哦，那么中间有两年改到明德高中，今天回到新民高中，觉得非常高兴。那最重要，我就是要谢谢各位老师、各位家长、各位同学的鼎力支持来参加这个活动哦。跟各位报告一下，过去15年来，从1991年开始我们办小尖兵到现在，已经有8000多位小朋友，像你们这样年纪的小朋友参加小尖兵的比赛。他们现在已经很多都进入职场、社会工作了，现在大概都30岁了吧？哦，所以你们想想看，小尖兵91年创办的时候，你们在哪里？可能还没出生吧？哦，或刚出生哦。所以15年的路不算短哦，所以过去15年来，我非常感谢，公共电视台，还有我们跟教育部合办这15年来哦，非常的，辛苦，但是我们觉得非常的很有成就感哦，因为看到各位在座在这边，平均过去已经有15年来已经有2000多个队伍参加，所以我刚刚计算了一下，我刚刚用简单的除法算了一下，平均每年大概有133个队伍来报名参加，那么今年比较少一点哦。可能大家有课业压力啦，或什么之类的，所以今年全部大概108队的队伍参加。台中区呢，中区的部分有35队，台北42队，南部大概31队哦。所以我们希望说，利用这个场合，在公开这边再希望呼吁一下各位全国的高中职学校的校长、老师还有家长能够支持这样的活动哦。那小尖兵过去几年来，我们办了小尖兵，前几年我们办了一个小尖兵回娘家，到我们外交部来。有几位已经在社会上做得很有声有色，包括我们有一位机师，长荣航空公司的机师，他以前我在纽约工作的时候6年多哦，1996年到02年在纽约，他那个时候还这么高的小朋友，他现在已经是航空公司长荣航空公司的机师了哦，而且今年4月的时候结婚，我去参加他的婚礼，哦，在新竹结婚的时候，那另外我们有一位台视的主播李婉如。哦，我想如果大家看电视一定看过他，他也经常出国做一些专题采访，他也是我们小尖兵第2届还是第3届的学姐哦。另外还有几位小尖兵曾经参加过的，现在在我们外交部工作，还有一位在海军的舰队做翻译官的哦，一个胡姐姐，她也是以前我们小尖兵团队出来的，所以还有一些在 Garmin 在像我们做那个汽车导航器的一个姐姐，她现在在台湾负责有关东北亚方面还有大陆的市场，所以小尖兵不仅给各位开一扇窗，让大家知道学习英文的重要，跟熟悉一点国际上事务的一些专业知识哦， 多多少少了解一下我们外交部做的工作是什么啊，顺便做一点植入式行销，就是啊，我们现在已经有拿中华民国护照到全世界各地去玩，有164个国家跟地区啊，你可以不要拿签证，你就可以拿着机票拿着护照就出去了啊。所以这个工作过去9年10年来我们做了很辛苦，但是也很有成果啊。所以你们小尖兵，高中生有小尖兵这样的计划，但是将来你们到了大学之后，我们外交部有规划像青年度假打工还有青年大使这样的计划，你们大学毕业之后到35岁之前你们如果愿意的话都可以选择，现在有15个国家可以让我们青年朋友到当地去度假打工啊，你不澳洲也好，还有欧洲有10个国家，包括法国、德国、比利时、波兰啊、匈牙利啊、奥地利、捷克、爱尔兰、英国都可以去啊。那亚洲地方就是有日本、韩国还有纽西兰跟澳洲，北美地方就是加拿大哦，那每个你可以去的地方大概半年到2年不等，啊，你可以不断地选择你要去的国家啊，哦，所以这个是外交部帮各位规划一个很好的，如果你规划了一个很好开拓国际视野跟国际接轨一个很好的机会跟平台，那特别帮教育部做一点植入式行销，因为教育部是合办单位，教育部青年发展署他们有一个贷款的计划啊，你不管你出国游学2个礼拜以上，还是出国这个度假打工，甚至游学，你都可以跟教育部申请。贷款的计划最多可以贷款到12万，每个月的这个利息大概2.5%吧，所以平均你未来5年后摊还，平均每个月你只要还给政府2500块台币就可以。所以你如果说毕业之后没有第一桶金，爸爸妈妈也没有给你钱可以出国，你可以跟教育部的青年发展署申请这样的一个贷款计划，可以资助你出国旅游啊，或者是壮游之类的。那在我不耽搁比赛的时间啊，我讲话讲到这里，那也谢谢各位来参加，然后我们希望今天各位好好的拿出平常心，把你最好的自我展现出来，然后明天我们2天课程这个比赛结束之后啊，会选出6个队伍，到12月初的时候会跟北区跟南区的总共18支队伍会在台北的公共电视台进行决赛。那么明年1、2月之间，我们已经在规划，准备安排优胜的3支队伍哦，到可能东南亚，可能其他的这个纽澳相当的国家或其他世界其他的国家去参访交流哦，时间大概是11天到12天左右哦，所以我希望能够在台北的公共电视台跟各位见面，然后也希望大家有追求最好的工作表现，这个成绩的表现，但是希望你们尽情的展现自我。谢谢各位，谢谢大家，谢谢。
接下来邀请的是新民高中代表外语中心黄俊明主任上台为大家讲几句话。
外交部李副执行长，我们的这个外交小尖兵的所有的评审老师，我们公示的工作同仁，以及今天所有来新民高中来参加外交小尖兵比赛的所有的队伍的老师跟同学，大家早安，大家好。今天早上呢，非常高兴，那仅代表呢，新民高中来欢迎所有的。所有人来到新民高中参赛。那新民高中的话呢，其实办理外交小尖兵已经有多年的经验。虽然呢过去2年呢并不在这边举办，但是今年我们非常荣幸，也很高兴又有这样的机会来为大家服务。所以呢学校全体上下呢都为了这样的一个活动精心的来准备。相信呢在这2天。也会展现最大的诚意来为大家做最好的服务。那今天呢所有的参赛队伍呢我看到都精神奕奕啊，那所以在这边除了欢迎我们所有的这个参赛队伍，那同时呢也先预祝我们所有的队伍呢在这2天都能够拿到最好的成绩。那外交小尖兵这个活动呢那已经相当的有这个历史啊，也可以说是年度的盛事，所以我想每个学校呢都非常精心的准备啊，包含我们自己学校呢也都积极的在参与啊，那这是一个非常好的活动。 那其实刚刚副座这边也提到这个在所有的这个国家，在国家来讲呢，也提供了很多的这个协助。那对于我们同学来讲呢，也是一个很好的机会，将来都有机会呢到国外去拓展视野，所以呢是非常难能可贵的。所以在这边再次的欢迎我们所有的来参加的队伍，那也预祝呢我们所有这两天的活动都能够顺利的进展，大家呢得到最好的成绩，谢谢。
谢谢以上贵宾。第一队表演题目是 Light Up Our Torch， 计时开始。
Hey, did you know there are many foreigners don't know anything about Taiwan?
I don't think so. I think they know.
Hold on, let me show you. Excuse me.Do you know what is Taiwan?
Taiwan? What is Taiwan? I don't know. WTF! But you're in Taiwan!
Yeah.
This is Taiwan! Taiwan? I saw it was called Chinese Taipei!
OMG! I can't believe this! We need to educate these foreigners! Maybe we can do something to make Taiwan belong to the world! Yes, we need to light up the torch about Taiwan!
I have an idea. We can use couchsurfing to go around the world and spread the word about Taiwan.
But what is the couchsurfing?
Couchsurfing is a service like connect members to a global community of travelers.
Also, we can use couchsurfing to find a place to stay or share your home and hometown with travelers. Yeah, I have done it before and it's like homestay.The best of all, we can share our cultures and life experiences, and at the same time, we can learn a lot from other cultures, too.
Yes, this sounds wonderful. Let's do it!
Hey guys, check this out! I have found a few different places like can hold us in different countries.USA, England, and France!
Yeah,
that's wonderful!
Let's go!
Oh, hey yo! What's up, my friend? Welcome to the USA! Yeah!
For you.
Oh, how nice of you! And what is it?
Well, it is Taipei 101, and it's the 8th tallest building of the world.
It is located in Taipei, which is the capital of Taiwan.
Every year, there is a huge fireworks display on it.
Pew pew!
Wow, I didn't know anything about Taiwan before. In my OSO, it was called Chinese Taipei.I have to go visit Taiwan and see the beauty in person. Let's go!
Now let's go to England.
That's beautiful.
Oh, welcome to England. I hope you will enjoy your stay here. And are you from Korea?
No.
We are from Taiwan. Do you know the tea you have in tea time?
Yes, of course. Oh, forgot my rudeness. A cup of tea for you.And a cup of tea for you.
Thank you.
And a cup of tea for you.
Thank you.
Ding ding.
Oh.
We grew the best tea in Mount Ali.
Fantastic. I want to go to visit Taiwan immediately.
All right, let's go to our next destination, France.
Oh, bonjour! Welcome to France! Oh, and Max.
Oh no, stay away from me.
Why? This is how we greet in France. Falena, Bixi. Oh.
In Taiwan, we're greeting people by saying, Ni hao.
Ni hao.
Si hao.
Excellent. We will teach you more about our language. Now, it's time to
head home. Ding!
So, what did we learn from this trip?
Well, we learned a lot of new things and we did share a lot about our country.
Now, many people will know about Taiwan.
Yes, we need to get all the young people to do this, broaden the horizon and...
Light up the church about Taiwan!
Oh, I love Taiwan! A fantastic country and a cup of tea. Anyone?
Thank you!
Turn adversities into advantages through cultural exchange between Taiwan and Israel. 计时开始。
We don't even have to try. It's a way to... Oh no! Why does the water stop? Did you pay the water bill, Jenny?
Of course! I just did that 2 days ago.
Are you sure?
Quick, come on.
Hey!
Didn't you see the bulletin about water suspension from Taiwan Water Corporation?
The water suspension? I have never met this kind of situation before.
What?
Although 60% of the territory in Israel is desert, we make good use of water, such as the well-known technology, drip irrigation for planting.
It's incredible! When it comes to Israel, wars, drought, famine, and religious conflicts come into my mind.
I'm curious about how you turn difficulties into advantages. In Israel, the rate of recycling water is the highest around the world. 50% of water is from the seawater desalination. In addition, wastewater treatment is the main water resource as well.
To see is to believe. Let's visit your country and see how you recycle and treat wastewater well.
Then, using it to solve the problem of water shortage in Taiwan, even around the world.
No problem.
Let's go!
Oh my god, Daddy!
Chris!
Oh my god!
I miss you so much!
Oh. You look taller.
Yeah, thanks, I know.
Hey, Tom! This is my dad.
Nice to meet you, I'm Aaron.
Nice to meet you, I'm Jenny.
Nice to meet you, I'm Macy.
Hi, I'm Aaron.
Welcome to Israel. Let me show around.
Hey, what's that?
I have never seen a drinking fountain on the street before. Why did they put that on the street?
The company, Kawush Water, invented this device. They place several stations in the city, and they're available to have a transit network online.
Then just use a keychain to sensor and logging when you fill bottles. With the sensor, the wastewater station is able to track how much water has been consumed, as well as how many plastic bottles have been kept out of the waste.
That's so brilliant! Not only does it save money, it also reduces the consumption of disposable plastic water bottles.
How does this taste?
The water tastes really good.
Really?
Yeah.
That's because the bottles are sanitized and the water is filtered before refilling.
We just got here and we've been impressed greatly by the advance and innovation in Israel. I think there are more for us to explore.
Yes, Israel is a country with many surprises. Are you ready for another surprise?
We surely are!
Why are tubes everywhere around the crop? Are those tubes for spraying water under the crops on a regular basis?
The tubes are for irrigation, but they don't spray water. Instead, they drip water into the crops, which is called drip irrigation.
I'm still confused. How does it work?
You can see that each tube is inserted into a soil. through which water will be delivered directly to the roots, making sure that each drop of water will be absorbed.
I remember the farmers usually use flood irrigation, in which all of the water will be poured on the crops.
Nah, this method will waste a great deal of water. Since over two-thirds of the lands here are deserts, we need to make sure every drop counts.
Not only do the tubes deliver water, it also distributes the fertilizers needed by the crops.
With this high efficient way of irrigation, the crop's quantity and productivity is highly raised, bringing great profits for us.
In Taiwan, many farms have great loss due to the drought. More and more cities are facing water rationing.
On to the natural adversity, we focus on how to recycle the wastewater. Thanks to the innovative technology, over 80% of the wastewater, after being processed, can be turned into drinkable water.
I just got an idea!
What?
How about filming what we see here in Israel and then post this video online? It's really an inspirational role model for us to learn.
With the video spread online, we can raise public awareness toward water resource and get inspired.
What a brilliant idea! Even though you aren't capable of creating this technology on your own, what you can do for a country is to stimulate the public awareness and start making people take it seriously.
For those who don't go overseas, this video will have them exposed to the different culture. Let's have Taiwanese experience what we see here through our eyes.
Attention, bow.
Thank you for your watching.
第三对表演题目是 Small Island, Big Song, 计时开始。
Based on a true story.
5 minutes, Mr. Cole!
Sure! Hello?
Yes, what do you want?
Are you Mr. Tim Cole, the young talented producer?
Yes, that's me. What can I do for you?
I came here on the same flight as you.
Congratulations! Look, I'm really busy here!
4 minutes, Mr. Cole!
Thank you!
Tim, who's this guy?
I have no idea, Baobao.
I'm Sam Reynolds!
And that's supposed to impress us?
I have a vlog channel on YouTube. Sam is on fire. Have you heard of it?
No.
Well, anyway, I'm here because the airline gave me your suitcase. And I believe they give me yours as well.
Really? I hadn't noticed.
We've been really busy.
What are you doing here in Malaysia anyway?
Oh, we're recording a dancing and singing video featuring native Taiwanese dancers.
It's for everyone, of course.
Yes, but our target audience is the native populations of the islands of Pacific and Indian Oceans.
But why record it here instead of in Taiwan?
It all has to do with our project, Small Island, Big Song.
What's that?
Our goal is to promote unity and cooperation between the tribes of Australasia, located, as I mentioned, throughout the Indian and Pacific Oceans.
They are connected?
Indeed, and their origins can be traced back over 5,000 years to the shores of Taiwan.
Really? Man, I should do a vlog about this.
Many people have no idea that in ancient times, Taiwanese Aboriginals spread out across the waters, eventually reaching as far west as Madagascar and east to Easter Island near Chile.
So, the native populations of those islands are linked?
Historically, yes. The Maori in New Zealand, Indonesians, Malaysians, Filipinos, the Polynesians, and the Malagasy of Madagascar can all trace their roots back to those daring Taiwanese explorers.
They all share a common heritage bound by courage, culture, and song.
Wait. What's that? It looks kind of awkward.
Oh, that's a nose flute from,
New Zealand!
Yes!
And it represents,
perseverance.
That's right.
Oh, is it time for lunch? Is that firewood for a barbecue?
Barbecue?
You really are a moron, aren't you?
What?
Nothing. This is a crack drum from Taiwan, representing harmony, and we are trying to set up for the performance.
Oh, I can help. Let me get that thing.
Whoa!
How romantic. Can you two step 13 help get us set up?
Flirting?
Sorry. No time for romance now. What is that thing anyway?
Oh, it's a xylophone. It represents the enthusiasm of the people of Madagascar.
That's fascinating. My subscribers are gonna love this.
The Australasian tribes represent one of the world's greatest civilizations, with over 250 million people covering half the surface of the Earth.
Amazing. How about you two? How did you two meet?
Tim and I were both interested in the music of the tribes of the Pacific. We met at an Aboriginal music concert.
Mr. Cole!
We both noticed that the musical style and language used during the concert were very similar to those used by the native people of our respective countries, Australia for me and Taiwan for Baba.
We did some research and found that many native Australasian cultures are distantly related.
Mr. Cole!
What's that woman keep trying to warn you about?
Because we're going to start a recording in...
1 minute!
1 minute?
Look, we have to get ready for the show. Could you go away now?
Okay.
Look, is this performance important to you or not?
Of course!
This concert should help this community get some badly needed attention. They have been losing their land to the effect of global climate change, so we have to get ready for the show.
Fine, let's go, Baba.
All right, I think we're ready to go now.
Okay, get into position.
I should get my vlog started. Battery is dead.
What?
Ladies and gentlemen,
thank you!
第四队表演题目是 One of Our Own, 计时开始。
It's a true story of a student from our school who auditioned for the same young diploma contest. Uncertain of what she wanted to do, Shola Cho hoped to find something she loved and was determined to find success.
There's a Pikachu beside your leg. Lucky to... How was the school day?
It was fine, nothing special.
So what do you want for lunch? Hamburgers or hot pot?
I don't know. What do you want?
Yesterday, you said you were tired of eating at home, so it's up to you. And speaking of decisions, have you thought about what you want to do this summer?
I don't know. I'm tired of studying. I just want to relax in front of the TV.
I thought you wanted to go on a school trip to Australia.
I do. I don't know.
Okay, let's have hamburgers first.
Oh, no!
So, what club did you decide to?
Audition for the Young Diploma Contest? Oh, join the dance club!
I can't decide.
Charlotte, you've been looking at that paper for an hour.
Yeah, but it's a hard decision.
What do you think? Maybe there'll be some cute boys in the math club.
Huh? This sounds like your decision last year to join the yoga club.
What was wrong with that? I learned a lot about myself through meditation.
Yeah, you learn the art of deep sleep and heavy snoring.
It was so relaxing. Charlotte, your English is so much better since coming back from Australia. You should go for the diploma contest. Come on, we'll do it together.
That could be interesting.
That would be great. Come on, let's go.
Okay, so what should we do first?
So how did the speech contest go?
I wasn't chosen. Neither was Sarah.
I'm so sorry to hear that.
Was that all? What a waste of time! I should have joined a
a dance club.
Don't say that. Did your English improve?
I don't know. I guess so.
So, what club will you join now?
Oh, please! Don't ask me to decide now!
Okay, let's have pizza!
Okay!
Oh, that was so sick!
Oh, no!
I'm sorry, I should introduce myself again. I'm a member of the organizing committee, but I'm also a humanities professor at National Taipei University.
Oh, wow! I've heard so much about your school! I'd love to go there!
Well, after seeing you at the conference this weekend, I think you'll be an outstanding student. I really hope you apply to our school.
Me? Really?
I hope to see you at school.
Congratulations, Charlotte. It looks like you found your way.
Thanks. How about let's have some fun to celebrate?
Okay, so what do you want? Hamburgers or hot dogs?
Hamburgers!
This September, Charlotte began studying public administration at National Taipei University. So, although our story has come to an end, one could say that the story for her is just beginning.
Snowlegs!
Dad! Let's put my stuff in the dorm first!
Okay. Oh, my snowlegs!
The 五队表演题目是 The Way to the World。计时开始。
你好
，Hello。
こんにちは。こんにちは。
Hello, everyone.
Hey, hello. I saw you on the airplane.
Yeah, I saw you also.
I like your drinks. Thank you. Did I hear you tell in my graduation that you were going to Tainan?
Yes, I have a friend there, and I'm going to visit him.
Why do you know where it is?
Of course, I'm from there. That's my home.
That's great. My name is Sasha.
Hi, my name is Vivian.
Hi, girls. I was wondering if you could help us.
I don't know if I can help, but she can. She's a Taiwanese.
Cool. And where are you from?
I'm from the USA.
Bonjour. I'm from France, and he is from Japan.
Konnichiwa. My name is Carrie. What's your name?
I'm Vivian, and this is Sasha.
I'm Carrie, and this is Alan. Are you guys friends?
No!
We just met each other on the airplane. I heard her say she was going to my hometown, so I introduced myself.
How do you guys know each other?
Oh, we just met on the plane as well. I'm on summer vacation from school, and I decided to travel around Taiwan.
I have a 2 weeks vacation from work, and people in Japan like to travel to Taiwan. We see a lot of pictures of Taiwan on TV.
You asked me if I could help you. What do you need help with?
We want to go to a real nice high-speed rail train station. Can you help us?
Of course. We are going there as well. Have you ever been on a high-speed train?
No, I haven't. We don't have that in the USA.We just have regular train service. Do you guys have high-speed train?
Yes, we do. It's called the Shinkansen. And it can go 320 kilometers an hour. It's very cool.
Sure, it's called the TGV.
We started in 1970. You can go to every part of the country, even through the mountains.
Wow, we have something in common in our culture. Let's try so later we can catch this shuttle bus to the high-speed train station. We don't have to pay if we buy train tickets.
So now, it is summer.
Is there any special festival Taiwan celebrates in the summer?
No, not really. We just celebrate Dragon Boat Festival in June, and the next one will be the Moon Festival in September.
I read in my travel book that Taiwan has many fun festivals and holidays.
Yes, that's true. We celebrate six major festivals. Chinese New Year is the biggest one since we get a day off and everyone goes home to see family. How about your culture?
We have 15 national holidays in 1 year. Over there are 4 different things. And the best part is called the Golden Week. 15 holidays? 1 week of vacation at Chinese New Year? That's crazy! We only get 10 days of a year. The biggest one is Christmas and Bastille Day. The Bastille Day is our national birthday.
The USA is like that as well.
We only get 10 days off. The biggest is Thanksgiving Day, where people get to go home for 4 or 5 days to be with their family. Then it's Christmas and our national holiday on July 4th.
Hey, we are here!
I'm kind of getting hungry. Can we get a snack?
Oh, me too!
So, what kind of snack do you eat in your culture?
Well, most people in America will eat a piece of pizza, or a hot dog, or a small sandwich and drink of some kind.
In France, it is kind of the same. Many people like pizza, but most of them will have a sandwich with cheese and salad.
That's very different than in Japan. People will eat a sushi roll, or small bowl, or hot soup, or noodles. We don't eat much Western food there.
So,
what kinds of food do people in Taiwan eat?
Well, many people like duck head on a stick.
Oh!
Some people eat chicken as tall on a stick.
Oh!
Some people eat 1,000-year-old TX on a stick.
Jesus!
My favorite is stinky tofu. It's very good.
Oh! I guess there are something that are very different in our culture. I don't feel hungry now.
I don't feel hungry either.
Okay, this is it. We are heading south and you guys are heading north to Taipei.
Oh, thank you for your help. It was nice meeting you both.
Oh, thank you so much for everything.
Bye bye, take care.
Thank you everyone.
Fight for gender equality, homosexual go. 计时开始。
Here we are!
Is this what you call the paradise for Pokemon Go?
Don't you see thousands of players walking around?
Let's see what special Pokemon we can catch here.
Diverse genders equal love! Diverse genders equal love!
Hello, I'm Emma. Welcome to join our Taiwan LGBT Pride Parade.
Nice to meet you, Emma. My name is Ryan. I'm glad to join this parade. Are you a homosexual?
No, I'm not. I come from the US. I was adopted by a Taiwanese lesbian couple in kindergarten. That's why I joined the parade every year since 2003. And I want to do something for my lovely parents and homosexual friends.
I admire your courage to do whatever you want. Fearless of others' judgment and misunderstanding.
Hey, Doris, look, it's a gay parade.
Come on, those guys are extremely abnormal people.
Gee, isn't that Ryan? How come he shows up in this parade? Ryan!
Gosh!
Ryan! What? Why are you here?
I...
Anything wrong?
Don't tell me that. You are a gay?
Come on, that's fine. Now that we meet here, let's Pokemon Go together.
Shut up! Ryan, I want you to tell me what's going on.
Actually, I like boys.
Excuse me?
I like boys.
What? I can't believe it.
Why are you so surprised? Homosexual marriage is even legal in my hometown, Brazil, and the other 15 countries now. It's normal.
Hey, my parents treat me just like your parents.
So, you become a lesbian too?
I support homosexuals, but I'm not. It's from my parents that I realize love crosses the gender boundaries.
Ladies, true love.
Homosexuality isn't caused by mental problems or physical defects. They just fall in love with the same sex. To tell the truth, I really appreciate that Ryan stands out.
Enough! I will never accept homosexuals. Ryan, you fooled our friendship for so long.
Come on, I choose to be true to myself.
I don't want to see you anymore.
Doris, don't be like that. Wait for me.
See, this is a cost. I pay for coming out.
Don't be sad.
Doris and Eric! Doris!
Eric!
I'm here!
Ryan! It's Eric!
Where is Doris?
Help! Help!
It's Doris! Emma, please take care of Eric! Doris! Doris!
Ryan, I say many words that hurt you, but you still risk your life for me. How terribly guilty I feel!
Doris, what are friends for?
In fact, I just can't stand that my wish to be in love with someone I like is smashed!
What?
But seeing so many parade goers stop to help the victim, despite the great danger, now I feel quite ambivalent.
Doris, actually, homosexuals are no different from us.
Give me some time. I will persuade myself from knowing Ryan again.
I'm not a fan at all.
Wait!
Hey, do your Pokemon go all the way to the airport?
Of course not. I decided to help my best friend Ryan with actions.
Would like to.
Fight for gender equality, homosexual girl.
Bob.
Thanks.
第7队表演题目是 The Corner in Cities， 计时开始。
Oh, baby, you brought me so many gorgeous dresses.
Of course, because you are my dear sweetheart.
I do wanna eat something special, please.
Piece of cake.
So, I can cook better than that.
Oh, of course. What you cook is the most delicious. Never come here alone.
What happened to you? Oh my god! Oh my god! My burnout! Help! Help! Help!
Help! Who is right now?
Girls, we need a hand. We are on the bureau of department store on Banana Street. Don't touch him! No! Get away from us!
Oh, you have to do that!
You act like a doctor.
I was a doctor before.
How come homeless now? How could it be?
Will you have an old woman with disability if you are boss? Is stable. Just take a rest.
Oh, I appreciate your help. Honestly speaking, I always think homeless are dirty and horrible. It seems to me that they will attack me. And you change my view.
Have you ever seen a homeless hit the headline? We are not the people you guys think about. We don't do any harm to people. In contrast, we were edged out by the society on purpose. Not long ago, someone wetted the ground in the park by spraying high pressure water on a freezing night. His action made us no place to sleep.
How can you say that you are caught by us? There are so many charities helping homeless like you, and we donate money and food to you, don't we?
Guess what? A warm bath and a bottle of wine. Which one will I choose? Without hesitation. Why? Why? Our lives are meaningless. What we have is nothing but stay alive.
Your attitude is so negative. Since you have a doctor's certificate, why not apply a job instead of complain? No wonder you are homeless now.
That's because you don't understand us. In fact, we have no choice but to wander around. We sleep in the park not because we are lazy.
So, what is your no choice but to?
I was a surgeon in my hometown 10 years ago, but unfortunately, I got a severe brain fever. Even though I survived, the brain damage led to my trembling hands, so I got fired.
What about your savvy?
What's worse, all my money invested by my husband in the stock market was gone. We were in debt. Then, my irresponsible husband ran away. And right now, my joints are too chaffy to labor. So, I have no choice but to fall around within alleys and streets.
Well, no one is willing to become the homeless.
So do you know the reason of no choice but to?
What can we do to help you out?
If someone give me a job, I'll take it. After all, it is good to do something meaningful as a human being.
Let me search for.
That's a movie, let's play it.
Hello everyone, we are the Homeless Taiwan, which focuses on vanguard artists closely, and we understand their status, such as how old they are, how long they've wandered around, and how their health conditions are. We are implementing the project called Hidden Taipei, which changed some of land to be our guides and bring us to explore the unknown areas in Taipei City. We also promote the activity of youth vanguardism, which lets everyone experience the pain of a vanguard life. This activity aims to arouse the participant's empathy, and they will no longer despise them.
But as a young, how can we do to help them?
Actually, you only have to give us a smile instead of avoiding eye contact when you see us on the street. That will be the best encouragement. Thank you.
Thank you.
第八队表演题目是 Foreign Returned， 计时开始。
Hi, I'm Eric. I graduated from the college 6 months ago.
My mom ever told me that if I got a diploma from a good college, I would get a good job. But I'm still looking for a job now, so what can I do?
Eric, how's it going?
Do you still look for a job? Yeah, I'm so depressed. My parents told me that I can get a good job and earn more money. They nag me every day and give me a lot of pressure. What about you?
Nothing new. By the way, there's a job opening in my company. It not only you can develop your expertise and professionalism, but also you can be on a good salary. But you have to stay at America 2 years at least.
That's all right. I hope to have new experiences, to see new things, to meet new people, and learn more about the world and myself. It will be a good chance to enrich my life. Mom, I got a job!
Really? Wonderful. I'm so glad to hear that.
But I have to stay in America for 2 years.
What? America? 2 years? No, no, no. I don't agree you to go there. Do you know there are many serious security problems in America, such as a terrorist attack and proliferation of guns? I'm so worried about that.
Don't worry, Mom. I'll be careful.
What's more, you have to spend more money on medical costs and the high cost of health insurance. I don't think you save much money.
Mom, please support me. I don't want to miss this good chance to expand my field of view and worldwide perspective.
I still want you to think twice.
Please, Mom!
Welcome home, Eric. You look good and comfortable.
Congratulations! We are so glad to hear that you got promoted.
So we hold a party to celebrate your promotion and return.
Thanks, guys!
Eric, can you show us the interesting or a different experiment when you work overseas?
Working abroad provides me a chance to expand my field of view and helps me understand and analyze problems and phenomena from a longer-term worldwide perspective.
Indeed. Working overseas has many advantages to expand our worldview, including experiencing different cultures and build cultural awareness. Besides, we can learn new working styles through international networks.
Going abroad is a good way to expand our worldviews, such as a good way of living in a foreign. That is a good living.
America is called a melt pot. This means that people and traditions from other countries and cultures are more visible and celebrated. Since it's highly likely you'll come across someone who is different to you or a situation that is unfamiliar, it's definitely helpful to know how you can become aware and understanding of other cultures. However, trying to understand cultural differences can open you up to a whole lot of new and exciting experiences.
I'm so glad that you get an excellent chance to expand for worldviews. That is, worldviews is framework, we believe, and learn more from your talk. So tolerance to me means you should be respect any person. So we promote who is different from you. Everyone should be treated equally because no one is worthless.
There are many ways to expand our worldview, such as traveling and reading about another country and cultures.
Expanding your worldview helps you develop as a human being. You will grow to better understand people and learn to realize people's actions and behavior.
So, never stop discovering the world!
Wow.
第九队表演题目是 A life-changing cultural experience. 计时开始。
So, what are you guys taking to Vietnam this year?
Wait, we have to take something?
Duh! Of course! I'm taking some shoes for them. Because I read about the sand flea foot infection.
Then I'll take some books there to teach them how to read in English.
You guys are so not creative. I am going to bring something amazing there.
What is it?
Ta-da! A DIY air cooling device. Isn't it cool? Isn't it cool?
I have no idea what I'm going to take.
Well, you'd better come up with something soon. All right, guys, let's start packing.
What should I take? I don't even know
if students in Vietnam need dolphins. Ah, I can take that.
Ah, this is so frustrating. They all wear shoes.
Even Taiwanese businesses set up footwear factories here and sell shoes at affordable prices.
Oh, well, at least you don't have to carry a heavy stack of books. Ugh. I didn't know their English was this good.
And quite a few of them also speak French because of the country's history.
And my cooling device is clearly no competition for their air conditioners.
Even if they didn't have air conditioners, the use of electric fans is common here.
We didn't even realize that globalization is so much larger than we imagined in Southeast Asia. But wait, since you talk that much, what exactly did you bring?
I brought Taiwan here.
You brought Taiwan here? Where?
Here. And I thought we could integrate parts of our cultures, like cooking and puppetry. Everyone, attention, please.
We are puppets from Taiwan.
I have to win a mochi competition to be the crown prince.
Well, you can make them using rice that represents the wide sky and wrap the mochi with green leaves that represent our lovely earth.
Hey, look, they're telling the tale of the origin of mochi.
Yeah, that's an interesting way of telling the folklore.
Yes, it's your famous folklore using our traditional puppetry. Do you want to play with them?
Why not?
So, where did you say you're from, puppets?
We
are from Taiwan.
Yes, from Taiwan.
Taiwan, I've heard of it. But I have to say, I don't know too much about it, except that there's a tall building. Taipei 101?
That's right. Not only that, Taiwan and Vietnam are major trading partners in Asia. Each side spends billions of dollars on trade with each other.
That much?
Not just that. Both Taiwan and Vietnam celebrate similar holidays, such as Moon Festival and Lunar New Year.
And I think both our countries have vibrant cultures.
It does sound like we're a lot more connected than we have imagined.
This is so interesting.
Okay, I'll talk to you guys when I come back. Okay, bye. So, what are you guys packing to take to Indonesia this time?
I searched the website of our Ministry of Foreign Affairs and found that they have this beautiful traditional shop.
I know, it's Batik.
Bingo, I'm taking this.
And I spoke with my cousin who's working there and found out they love spicy food. So, I'm taking some Taiwanese hot sauce for them to try.
Wow, look at you guys being so cultured. It does look like we have a better understanding of international cultural exchange.
Since you're being so knowledgeable, what are you going to take?
Our beloved Taiwan, of course. Bao.
Thank you.
The 10th performance theme is Individually, we are one drop. Together, we are an ocean. 计时开始.
I really like this new game called Pokemon Go. Not only does it remind me so much of my childhood memories, but it also gives me the opportunity to bring animations to life.
This game's on fire. I can't get enough of it. I wonder what it's like to be in a real Pokemon world, if that world really does exist. I want to create my own Pokemon.
Is this even real? Man, this game is off the hook. Hold on, why is my screen flashing? And where are all the Pokemons? Something's going on. Whoa, who did that?
Whoa, what is this place? Hold on, I'm in the Pokemon world.
Holy moly, is this a dream come true? Am I really in the Pokemon world?
Yes, you are!
Let's go and catch some real Pokemon!
Let's go!
That hurts. Who would do such a horrible thing but litter in public? Whoever did this must have not realized that it could cause a huge environmental hazard.
What happened to you?
I was walking on the street playing Pokemon Go, and all of a sudden, I almost got hit by a water bottle and tripped over by a banana peel. And now I'm here. Where am I?
Who cares? It's not a big deal anyways. Everyone litters. It's just human nature.
Speaking of nature, welcome to the Pokemon world!
The Pokemon world?
Hey guys, look. Is that a Pokestop?
Ew! What are these?
What is that?
Who? Me? Or are you referring to the human nature? Can't you see? This is a world that your human created. And you also created me, your masterpiece. Trash mod.
Trash mod? What a funny name. No wonder it looks so ugly and stinks so bad.
Yeah, what does it have to do with us humans anyways?
Don't you understand? Humans have been littering for decades. This is an image of the real world in 5 years.
Are you serious? This can't be real, right?
Take a look. This is reality. If you don't take immediate action, this is what the environment will become. Look. All of you, are you ready to live in these kind of world?
No, no. Say no more. You are making this up, right? We can't possibly ruin Earth, can we?
Keep in mind, there are approximately 7.4 billion people, and the world generates about 1.3 billion tons of waste per year.
Huh?
Okay, let me break it down for you. On average, every person generates 2 kilograms of trash per day. It's like throwing away 10 uneaten Big Macs.
That's a lot of trash and a lot of Big Macs.
Correct. Trash is toxic. More than 60,000 products contain toxic waste, and it severely affects our health. I see Pokemon throwing up, having stomach pain, diarrhea, and having a difficult time breathing. They've gotten weaker, and some have already gone extinct.
I didn't know that garbage was such a serious problem. We need to start taking actions to protect our Earth.
But how? How can we help? We're just teenagers.
Well, think about what your country does to minimize trash. Perhaps you will discover a suitable solution from one another.
Oh, I know!
Me too!
Same here.
Well, it looks like both of our world will only see better from this point forward.
Thanks for the information from my international friend Jean and Richard. A group of Japanese scientists have discovered the first known bacteria that is able to eat plastic trash. According to the World Economic Forum, an estimated 342 million tons of plastic waste are produced every year worldwide, while only 14% is collected for recycling. Ever since Adrianella Sakaiensis 201F6 has been brought to public, it has tremendously reduced plastic waste on a global scale and improved our environment.
There's a project called the Ocean Cleanup. Bojan Slate, the founder of the project, created a floating barrier that is able to capture any ocean debris within 100 kilometers, almost half the Great Pacific Ocean patch in 10 years. This is great for the US. After all, we are top 5 countries that generate the most trash in the world.
Taiwan has done a tremendous job at recycling. We use plastic bottles to make soccer jerseys. This is very important because not only does it reduce trash, but it also creates job opportunities. It's a win-win situation.
With effort,
technology,
creativity,
and teamwork,
we can all achieve global vision through user change. Thank you.
第十一队表演题目是 I, Taiwan, 计时开始。
Oh. Are you okay?
No.
Is there something wrong with your tooth?
Yeah, it has been bothering me for almost a month.
Then why not visit a dentist?
It cost an arm and a leg just for a simple diagnosis, and it cost £50 just to see a doctor, and at least £150 to get one tooth pulled.
Wow, that's a lot. You know, in Taiwan, for that much money, you could see a doctor 50 times. I'm in the wrong country to be a dentist.
Wait, what? You are a dentist? What coincidence?
Come to my clinic after we arrive Taiwan. Let me show you around.
That'll be great. I heard that Taiwan ranks the top medical technology in Asia. Is that true?
Yeah. What's more, Taiwan is also the top three countries throughout the world with the best medical treatment.
That's just unreal. Oh, I really need to get my tooth checked.
Well, the plane is about to land. Let's buckle up.
Okay. Dentists are amazing.
Come in.
Hello, Mrs. Clark. Good afternoon, Mrs. Lin. Thank you for seeing me.
Welcome to Taiwan. Have a seat.
Thank you.
How was your trip over here?
It was very smooth. By the way, I met a dentist and she fixed my teeth just for 50 NT.
Yes, Taiwanese dentists are the best in the world. I'm glad you are okay.
Thanks.
So, tell me about yourself.
I have been an educator for about 5 years, and I wanted to learn and challenge myself to become a global educator.
Then, why Taiwan?
My research tells me that Taiwan has the most amounts of private school per person in the world.
That's true. It is highly competitive here and pushes us to be great.
And that's what I want, to learn and challenge myself to be the best.
Well, you have come to the right place. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Oh gosh, where am I now? I need to find a place to settle down tonight. So now, should I turn right?
Apple pen.
Should I
gummy bear. Gummy bear. Black.
Oh gosh. Or turn black back to right.
I can't understand what they're teaching my grandson in
school. Back to
it's left. Nonsense. Hey, excuse me.
Yes?
Do you know what an apple pen is?
What?
Apple pen.
Maybe it is a pen and it's made of an apple?
Well, maybe she's right.
Perhaps.
By the way, what are you looking for?
Well, I'm looking for a place to settle down tonight.
A place to stay? We have an apartment.
We can show it to you. It is a 2-bedroom, 1 living room, 1 bathroom apartment. Is it how much?
It is 10,000 NT.
10,000 NT per week?
No, silly. It's per month.
10,000 NT per month? That's really cheap.
Even though Taiwan is small, but everything is reasonable. Here, come with us.
Hey, TV, have you done your homework?
Of course, I always finish my homework on time.
Okay, be careful.
Okay, Mom.
Goodness, why your lecture keep play outside at such a late night?
Well, Taiwan is really safe.
Don't you feel any danger?
No, not at all. The police always come around to patrol regularly.
Plus, we have CCTV cameras everywhere, even the trees.
So, crime rate is low here?
Yes, we are the safest country in Asia.
Now I see. You have great country. Now I understand
Y-U-O-I Taiwan.
Thank you.
Thank you. 第十二队表演题目是 Have Fun in the Sky， 计时开始。
Hello everyone, this is Dolly from XTV News. We are at the major disaster area of Japan earthquake, Fukushima. The magnitude 7.5 earthquake hit at the area at 10:57 and caused severe damage. We will continue updating for you.
Disaster happened again in Japan.
Absolutely. It was the third one in a year. As one part of the world, I think we should do something to the needs now.
Let's raise funds for our dream with all the cosmic.
Japan earthquake. Would you like to help us out with some donation here?
Are you guys students? How nice of you!
We believe that we should do something to help.
Oh, right.
What do you think we should do next?
Since we're from medical school, I think we can join the rescue team and support the local hospitals.
Like this time, it's not like anything I have ever seen. You know what? I couldn't even have time to escape. By the way, where's my girlfriend? Where is she? Is she okay? We promise each other that no matter how difficult the future will become, we will stick together and face difficulties. But now I couldn't even reach her. Please tell me where she is.
Sir, please calm down. Maybe you just lost her contact at the moment. There must be some way to find her.
Don't worry, everything will be fine.
There is a magnitude 6.5 earthquake happened in southern part of Taiwan at 4:32. Taiwan? Oh, I wonder whether those college students who helped me are doing fine. Now is the time I return their favor. Hello? Hello?
Who is it?
This is a representative of Japan College School Association. Is everything all right with you? How's the damage?
We're fine. 1,000 Taiwan is severely destroyed. We need your help.
I'll be right there.
So, were you the one studying the fundraising throughout Japan, like that year?
It didn't occur to me that we can all do a favor for our own countries as a college student.
There's no way that we only care about two countries while being in a diplomatic team.
So,
we should launch an international team association and ask anyone who wants to join us.
How about calling it Mutual Cooperation of Youth Organization?
Then we must toast for our world and celebrate the birth of another mutual association.
Gao.
Thank you.
Number 13 Catch Me, Please. 计时开始。
Wow, the Parthenon! It looks so much bigger than I thought.
Well, I'm glad you finally had the chance to come here and see it. It's a real treasure here for us here in Greece.
I studied about this place back in Taiwan, but now I'm actually here.
Touching it, it just feels so amazing.
Whoa, just don't break it. You know, that's over 2,500 years old.
I can't believe I've been exchange students here for 3 months already. It has opened my eyes.
And for me too. I still can't believe that in your country, you have to not only go to school all day, but then also at night.
Oh yes, we definitely study a lot in Taiwan. We hardly have any time to go out and be free like you are here.
That's true. Still, I wouldn't mind living in a more economically stable and safe country like you have.
Well, no place is perfect. Hey, speaking of free time, let's play something that both our countries are addicted to.
Do you mean Pokemon Go? Good idea. Let's catch them.
Oh, there is one. Oh, I see it. It's a Poliwag. Now throw some Pokeballs at it.
Yeah, gotcha.
Me too. Cool.
Let's see if there are more.
Hey, there's a Pikachu!
Where? I don't see it. It's not in my phone.
Over there.
Right by the...
Wait a second. That's
over
not
here.
The Pikachu.
Over here.
I'm over here. I'm a real Pikachu. So come and catch me.
That's just a little boy dressed up in a Pikachu costume.
No, I'm not. I'm a real Pikachu. So come and catch me.
Okay, little boy. Go home and find your mama. We want to catch real Pokemons.
But I'm real and very rare. Look, I'll even let you catch me. So quick, throw a Pokeball at me and take me away from here, please.
Brother, where are you? Oh, here you are. Did you ask another person to catch you in a Pokeball? I'm sorry about my little brother. I'll take him away.
Hold on, you guys. Why do you guys want to leave this place? Greece is just so wonderful.
Well, we're actually refugees from Syria. We had to leave our country because of the civil war there. It might seem nice to you, but for Syrian refugees like us, we're living here with almost no food, money, or safety.
But where are your parents, though? Can't they take you to somewhere safe?
Mommy and Daddy were died 2 years ago when the bad men invaded our town.
We were a few of the lucky ones who escaped from that attack. We were forced to leave our home in Syria just to arrive in a place where it seemed no one cares about us. It has been really hard.
I'm really sorry to hear that, but can I ask why your brother is wearing a Pikachu costume?
Because everyone is playing Pokemon and in order to get noticed.
I thought that if I dressed up like a Pikachu, people could finally take notice of us and bring us to a better life. So please, take me away from here and put me into a cell phone, please.
I'm really sorry, but it just doesn't work like that.
Come on, brother. I told you, the world doesn't care about us. It seems all they care about now is the stupid cell phone game. Let's go.
Hold on. I had no idea how hard it has been for you Syrian refugees. You really have opened our eyes to a very important issue. But I think I may know a way to remind the world what you're going through that may help you. Just stand there.
Hi. My name is Tina from Taiwan, and I'm making this video here in Greece is to remind the world about the continuing Syrian refugee crisis.
Which Syrian refugee crisis may seem far away from you, but we hope you take the time to look away from Pokemon and consider the real problems people are facing all around you. We were just like you. We had a home, food, security.
A mommy and a daddy.
And all of that is gone now. But despite our problems, there are people like us suffering to live a better life. Don't feel sorry for us. Help people like us wherever you are.
And please, please share this video. Help us open the eyes and help the world. Thank you.
Hello, Youth For, Hello the World. 计时开始。
Zika virus has wreaked havoc in Brazil, particularly to pregnant women like myself, and continues to spread all over the world. This is Mina, reporting from Brazil.
I, Zika, rule the world. No! Zika is a nightmare.
I gotta do something.
Or it may come to Taiwan. But what can I do?
Come on, don't worry. Why not try me?
Who are you?
I'm Youth For, the most useful online communication platform in the world.
What can you do?
My main function is to provide a platform so youth around the world can exchange their points of view through essays. If they want to have a further discussion, they can use video chats and messenger. For example, you're interested in Zika?
Yeah.
Here, essays about Zika.
Wow, that's impressive.
Can I leave a message to the writers?
Sure. You've got a new message. User 123 requests to have a video chat with you.
Sure. Hello there. I'm Lisa from Taiwan. I'm impressed with your Zika essays. Wait, what's wrong with your faces?
Hola, this is Juliana from Brazil. Anna and I have to apologize for these mosquito bumps on our faces. I hope they're not too scary.
Yes, it is really awful. I hope I can do something to alleviate your pains. Oh, Anna and Juliana, I can do something here in Taiwan.
What? Tell us.
Mosquito nets. Zika is spread by mosquitoes. And we Taiwanese often use mosquito nets in summer to avoid getting bitten.
The nets? Fabulous!
We can donate the nets to the locals.
Taiwanese are very passionate about helping others in need. I'm sure we can gather a lot of mosquito nets.
Look forward to hearing from you.
Bye!
Welcome to Brazil, my friend.
Here are the mosquito nets I collected.
Then, let's deliver the nets to the locals.
Free nets! Free nets! Free from Zika!
I have a huge family. My grandpa, grandma, father, mother, aunties, uncles, sisters, brothers, daughters, and sons. I need a lot of nets.
Sure!
Obrigada!
But do all people in your country have a huge family? Yeah. What's the problem? We don't have enough nets.
Oh no!
We were given nets, but these nets are way too small for my big family. Useless. Can someone help us?
You've heard that. We're in trouble.
You are certainly right. Wait a second. Have you heard of crowdsourcing? Not only it is efficient, it is expedient.
Marvelous idea!
Crowdsourcing is the process of obtaining needed services, ideas, or materials by soliciting contributions online.
This way, we can gather the world power to raise enough funds for mosquito nets. Problem solved. Then what are you waiting for? Let's get started. here now lead a better life because of us and Youth 4.
Youth 4, Youth 4, did someone just mention my name? See, with a little bit of ingenious maneuver, there's nothing that you youth cannot do. You'll change the world.
Balam, balam.
You'll change the world.
Balam, balam.
Open your heart, meet some new friends around the world.
Around the world.
Share your ideas with all your friends and view the world in different ways. Expand your horizon, no one can beat you. You'll change the world.
You'll change the world.
Thank you.
第十五队表演题目是 World as One， 计时开始。
There are three students looking for their classroom. One is from Japan, another is from Korea, and the other is Taiwanese.
みなよ。
すみませんが、ねえ、その教室ではどういったらいいですか？
죄송한데뭐라고요
네저저그것이에너유가다오기다에너데스나
저는정말당신말이모르겠어요저이분사람아닙니다
Hi guys, since you two have some problems, what's wrong?
我来说跟你们说一点데스나아무래도와我知道还是在我这边데스나
Okay, calm down, calm down. You both understand what I just asked. That means you two can communicate in English. Why don't you just talk to each other in English?
Right, brilliant.
So now, what's your problem?
I'm looking for my classroom 205. I'm almost late.
Classroom 205? Really? We're in the same class.
What a coincidence. I know where it is. Let's go together.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I'm glad to see you all here in the first day for class. I'm Mr. Lin. I'm your teacher for this class, International Language and Culture.Taking this class is a way for you to understand more cultural differences by using the international language. And for each class, we'll have a specific topic that I've already posted on the net. I hope you all browse it and brought what we need for today.
Yes, we did!
That's great! Let's start the class today then. For the first hour, we're going to make you guys introduce yourselves and tell us about your personal background.Take me for example, I'm Sir Lin, you can just call me Michael. I'm now working in Taichung as a college English teacher. Tainan is my hometown. There's a famous tourist spot called Qingkan Tower. It was built in 1653, and now it's a first-class protected historical site. If any one of you want to visit Tainan, I can show you around. Now, who wants to go first?
I go first.
Okay, stand up please.
Hi, 皆様
Hi.
My name is Sano Take. I'm from Asakusa, Tokyo. There are two things you must know about Asakusa. First, Sensoji is the most famous and popular temple in Tokyo. Almost all tourists come to see when they visit Tokyo. Second, there is a classical character coming from Asakusa. Guess.
Classic character is the Chibi Maruko Jack.
No, you mean Chibi Maruko-chan. She is from Shizuokashi, the middle of Japan. So, guess again.
I don't know much about the Japanese manga. Is this Doraemon?
Doraemon is really a classical one, but not him. It's Leon Kankichi. Have you ever heard of him?
I should know that. That is one of my favorite characters.
Me too. I really like him. He is funny and always makes me laugh when I feel upset.
That's great.Through this practice, we can learn new things about each other. Keep going. Next one.
I want to be a second one.
Okay.
안녕하세요.
Hi.
My Korean name is Nara. You can just call me Nara. I got a special name. Nara in Korean means the country. I guess that's why I'm ambitious and want to know much about other countries. That's the reason why I come here.
That's good for you. It's good for a young person to have his or her own dream.
감사합니다 And from Seoul, it's the capital city in Korea. There's something you need to know. Recently, there's a box office hit taken in my hometown. It's a horror film. Don't know what is it?
That's easy. We Taiwanese like everything about Korea is Train to Busan, right?
Amazing! That's not even a question to you. Yes, it's Busan-hyung. Do you enjoy this film?
Of course, it's super scary, but I really care about characters too.
I've also heard about it, but still haven't got a chance to see it.
That's nice. Okay, so you're the last one. It's your turn now.
大家好
Hi.
I'm Jessie. I'm from Taichung, Taiwan. I grew up here, so I know the city inside out, including all the famous tourist spots near Taichung. If you guys want to have some fun after class, I can show you some great places.
That's great. The class is about to let you understand more about other people and their cultures. So next week, we're going to look through different food cultures about your country. Please be prepared. If there's no question about this class, I'll see you guys next time.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Lin. See you.
Thank you.
第十六队表演题目是 The Invisible Hands Behind the Success. 计时开始。
Shane Stark playing up in the lane.
Hi.
Against number 14, John Hargraves.
Hi. Hi. May I join you guys?
Sure.
Never seen you before. Are you the new student?
Yep, I'm new here.And I come from Taiwan.
Taiwan, cool. I'm from Jamaica.
Brazil.
And America. Glad to meet you.
Is it the basketball game of Olympics?
Yeah, it is. It was a good game. Most of the tournaments had delivered a fine competition.
Agree. Although there were some incidents during the events, I believe we held the event successfully.
Woohoo! We have won the most medals of all countries, like always.
You nailed it. But you know what?We broke the record of 100 meter dash by 9.81.
That's really something. As the home team of Olympics this year, we live up to everyone's expectation on soccer games. Winning medals on soccer games is just easy as pie.
How about yours? How many golden medals have you got?
This year, we only got one golden medal, which is earned by our amazing athlete.
Hey.是熟静
That's amazing! Medals of weightlifting are always in your palm.
True! It always hard to compete with you in this area.
What else have you got?
This year, we only got 3 medals. If it isn't for us, you guys may not perform this well, and the event won't go as smooth.
How's that?
We have contributed by ourselves by super tactile technology.The people to reduce the pollution from manufacturing and still present the best product as well.
Can you be more specific?
We turn PET bottle that people don every day into the high quality sportswears.
You mean like this?
Haha! Not exactly. I mean we can make that into that. After multiple position. First,squeeze the bottle into a huge plastic brick to reduce the chance pull difficulties. Then, we make sure all the bottles are clean, cool them into the little pieces, melt them with a high heat, fold them till they are thin as a silk. This will be the basic material of the fabric. The sportswear are easier for perspiration and a lot of leather than traditional fabric.And they even come with various colors.
Wow, they're gorgeous.
And we develop and produce the footwear specialized in springs again as well. Lots of athletes are diehard users of our shoes. Usain Bolt is one of diehard users.
That's Usain Bolt? You mean the fastest man in the world, the proud of our country.
Exactly.
Unbelievable, your guys are incredible.
I'm impressed. I didn't know Taiwan is the invisible hands of success in Olympic sport.
Same here. You guys turn waste into gold.
bank, it took many efforts, but we are proud of what we have achieved.
It's making me want to know more about Taiwan already. Maybe I should schedule some time to visit Taiwan.
Tell me for that. I also want to explore the country that makes the fastest man in the world.
What about... what about the upcoming winter vacation? It'll be so much fun.
Wally, welcome. I can be your tour guide.
Hey, the next one star. Let's continue watching.
Sure. Attention. Bow.
第十七队表演题目是 Global Dialogue， 计时开始。
Where are they? I can't wait until they arrive.
Me too. I'm sure they must be very interesting.
Hi, welcome to Taiwan. We're so excited to have you here. Wait, who are you talking to? Welcome to Taiwan. We're so...Please.
Stand here together.
Welcome to Taiwan. We're so excited to have you here. I'm Vincent.
And I'm Joy.
Yeah, let's get you guys settled in and maybe we can get you something to eat.
Gracias, you're so kind.
Oh, no worries, let's go.
But...
Are you guys coming?
Why wouldn't they talk to us last night?
Perhaps they were just shy. It was their first day in a new country.
Weren't we being friendly and very, very welcoming?
I suppose you're right.
If they're going to resist, then there's no need for us to be more accommodating than we've been.
You make a good point. Let's just focus on our project.
Whatever. Here. Create an application that introduces high school students to experiences and social information from across the globe.
No problem. In our last project, we created a similar app for Taiwan. It should be a piece of cake.
Hello. Sorry, we're late. We're speaking to the professor.
He said the two of us will work with you on the current project.
Really?
Yeah.
Here are the instructions. You guys can first go over there and read it. What is Mr. Peters thinking? He should have asked us. I don't want to work with them.
They could be helpful, perhaps.
Perhaps what? They don't even want to talk to us. Let's give them something else to do.
Okay, if you think it's a good idea.
Okay, I have an idea. In South Africa, we have created a software
that... Hannah, we have already started. You guys will take care of this element.
We have our local region covered. If only we can figure out what is trending in Americas.
Africa and Europe. We have done research there, so we have to.
Try harder. We have to make this globally applicable or it is pointless. There are so many students, but we need to add...
This region and the various social media platforms used here. And why...
Is this not working? We added amazing stories and students made short films for...
Everyone is viewing pleasure. Accessible to students all over.
But we can't reach out to anyone. We have...
To find content, otherwise being global, is not worth it. There
are too many factors that I don't understand. It's like we have part A, but missing...
Part B. We are getting Donald Butt.
Who's going to read our stories? We need to...
Make a breakthrough. Now it's...
Getting harder to find a way. I can't...
Please, that we're so close. I'm getting...
Really? Frustrated? Ah!
You guys okay?
Yes, we're... No. We're having a hard time reaching out to students beyond this region.
Can we take a look? Let's see. This is excellent. You guys have done a great job.
But we have less than 5,000 downloads. We need at least 50,000 for it to be called a success.
Wait,
I have an idea. Can I add my code to your program?
Yeah, sure. Let's see if it works.
There. Now we wait.
Well, honestly, thank you so much for your help.
Don't worry about it. Your app was a success. That's all that matters.
Our app. Your insight into our problem opened the door to a big new world.
I agree. We had part of the recipe, and you guys have the missing ingredients. Sorry for my behavior, dear. But why wouldn't you talk to us last night?
Oh, because we're tired. We want to go to bed, but we didn't want to offend you.
We should just talk to each other. We can open a global dialogue.
Just like our new app. That's a good name for it.
Global Dialogue!
Everyone,
thank you.
第十八队表演题目是 Global Youth Going Green， 计时开始。
Here we are in Berlin, finally! I'm so excited! Let's go meet up with Patrick and Mario! Hey, over here!
Hello, welcome to Germany. I'm Mario.
And this is Patrick.
I'll be hosting you during your stay.
I'm Andy, and this is Sherlock. Nice to meet you. We are glad to have this opportunity to visit your country on a working holiday. And thank you for hosting us.
It's our pleasure. Excuse me, but may I ask, why do you want to join this working holiday program?
Our mutual friend once visited Canada through a similar youth exchange program. His understanding of local cultures, as well as his global perspective, was greatly broadened.
I see. And what led you to visit Germany?
Actually, I've always dreamed about becoming an architect, and I'd like to take this opportunity to see some amazing German architecture.
And we also want to see the beautiful sights and taste the delicious food.
I'm dying for German beer and sausage!
Don't worry, we'll get to that later. Let's show you rock first.
Wow! The station is so huge!
Look! How special the design is! It's magnificent!
I've read a report that Berlin Central Station is a unique green building.
Look at the roof. It's made of glass. It lets the sunlight reach the platform below.
Yeah, the gas roof lets in natural light and saves energy.
The roof is installed with the largest solar panels in Berlin, which provide year-round electricity.
Oh, speaking of which, the Taiwan high-speed rail Changhua Station is a similar green building.
Yeah, it just started running last year. There is a huge skylight for whole lighting.
Hey! What are you doing? Why didn't you recycle your trash properly?
I did! I threw it in a plastic bottle bin!
By recycling properly, we mean tearing off a rubbish, removing the cap, crushing the bottle, and then putting each piece into separate bins.
Sorry, my bad.
That's a lot of work.
We should all do our part, right? Besides, the bottles can be recycled into poly bricks.
Poly bricks?
Since Andy and Shula came back to Taiwan, they've worked on designing the model of a green building. Now they're at Super Science High School Fair in Osaka, Japan, promoting their concept.
Wow! Your exhibit is so special! Where did you get the idea from?
We went to Germany on a working holiday. We're inspired by the buildings, such as the Berlin Central Station, the German Congress Building, and the Main Tower. We found that the Germans take environmental issues seriously. Their green buildings are cost efficient and sustainable.
Back in my country, the USA, there is a California Academy of Sciences. It's also a sustainable construction, made of recycled materials with natural lighting and a green roof.
Seems that breeze in.
Wow. Excuse me, I'm curious. Why we use the recycled plastic bottle as the building material?
They are easily available, but non-biodegradable. So we figured a way to make them into holy bricks.
I see. And what's the roof? Don't you?
We're inspired by the curved glass roof of the Berlin Central Station.
Oh, brilliant. But what happens when the house is no longer in use?
Well, it can be taken apart and put to other uses.
Wow, that's awesome.
You must have put in a lot of work.
That's the least we could do.
We hope to propose a solution for us and future generations.
What we do today will usher in a better tomorrow for all of us.
We believe that we, the younger generation in Taiwan, can make a world of difference by exchanging ideas and working together with our counterparts.
We, the youth of the universe, should tie up hand in hand.
第十九队表演题目是 Welcome to Taiwan， 计时开始。
Hello, nice to meet you.
Our soldiers, welcome to Taiwan. Taiwan is so beautiful and then,
wow, so beautiful.
And there are many
well-known
tourist attractions in Taiwan.
For instance, you can go to the Taipei 101, which is one of the tallest attractions of the world.
Next place I want to introduce are Hsinchu and Miaoli. Here full of the Hakka traditional culture and
southmost top of Kenting. Where is the paradise with the culture?
That's when you're traveling to Hualien.
To Hualien. And Taichung.
You can experience unique and regional culture and magnificent to Taroko.
Thank you.
The 二十队表演题目是 How a wonderful day in this world. 计时开始。
Time's up! Everybody back to your seats and continue studying!
Why can't I understand anything about bakery? I don't want to study anymore.
What's wrong? How can I help you?
No, leave me alone.
Hey, look! Do you only see the lamping happy? Hey, beware, wait for me! Look, what you think?
I didn't do anything wrong.
About apples?
Yeah, you two have a lot of video about Lisa. I have. Shut up! You really need to be quiet.
What's bothering you?
This is so hard. I can't cut the apple. It's okay, let me help you.
have the pen. I have the apple. Apple pen.
What are you doing?
Can go to see a movie on the weekend.
Great! There are nearby that we can go to.
Hey, what are you guys talking about?
Nothing, let's go home.
Why won't you let me join the conversation?
Who knows?
What did I do? I thought we were friends.
It was one of my favorites.
Yes, especially when the hero beats other villains. The stores were cheap and they had fashionable clothes.
Even the restaurant was delicious.
Hey, look! She's sitting alone. She looked like in a bad mood. Are you okay? What's the matter?
We don't want to treat you this way, but...
I just want to make everyone happy. What did I do wrong? We are sorry. We didn't know you felt this way. We misjudged you.
It's okay. I forgive you. All of you. I will still continue to spread joy to everyone.
I have an apple. I have a bread. Ooh, apple bread.
Apologizing does not always mean that you are wrong.
It just means that you value your friendship more than your ego.
Remember, spread the love wherever you go.
Bow.
Thank you.
第二十一对表演题目是 Greetings from the World， 计时开始。
Chuck is studying again. He's such a bookworm.
Hey, Penny, what are you reading?
Oh, it's about the president election in the U.S. next month.
Oh, it's Hillary. I bet she will win the election this time. She's my idol.
Well, I'm on Team Trump.
Hey, wait a minute. Hey, Chuck, who do you think will win the president election in U.S. this time?
Obama, I guess.
And Chuck, he's not even in the candidate list. Never mind.
She's so beautiful!
Oh, she's Vanessa, exchange student from Nigeria.
Hey, Vanessa, he's Chuck, and he'll be introduced our school to you.
What? But I don't even get a notification.
I think you just forgot it. Oh, we still have some things to do.
Yes, we're running out of time.
Take good care of her.
Vanessa, just follow him. Bye!
Wait! Follow me. This is a building. This is another building. This is a building again.
Hey! Do you know about reggae music?
Is that rock music or something? I bet it's noisy.
No!
Oh, Vanessa, there you are. It's time for the activities in a club.
Do you want to join us?
Okay, I'm bored anyway.
She feels I'm boring? Where are they?
It's been so long.
Wait, they just leave me behind?
What is wrong with him?
Hey, Chuck, are you okay?
Oh, Vanessa, it's awkward. I mean, everyone could have a long conversation with you easily. You talk about people, cultures, and even political views about Nigeria. I always study hard and prepare for every test with my whole heart. I just don't get it.
I think you get it the wrong way. Knowledge isn't only in the textbooks. It's also in the world you live.
Does that mean we have to go abroad more often?
Not really. Internet, newspaper, magazines, you can have good use of them. Having a wide vision doesn't always mean you have to go abroad. Those are good ways for you to approach and look into global issues.
Ah, speaking of the globe, I have some ideas to expanding our global vision. There's a website called Postcrossing, and I've been using it for a while. It enables us to exchange postcards with people all around the world. By doing this, we can not only spread Taiwan's culture and information to the foreigners, but we can also get to learn more about their cultures by the postcards instead.
Hey guys, it reminds me of the trip to Germany last year. At first, I thought we would just be hanging around, eat sausages, or taking selfies in some scenic spots. On the contrary, we not only attended the beer festival, but also make some new friends. They even walked me through the history of it.
Wow! It never occurred to me that a world outside of textbooks can be so interesting and meaningful.
Yes, especially when you really look into the place you go. And you can not only see the true color of the city, but also get to know more about the country.
Oh, I nearly forget something. There's a international volunteers application. I think we should give it a try.
How about you, Chuck?
So I have a reading club on that day. I will go for my better life.
Let it go, let it go. Your world is more than books and text. Take a step, open mind, and the world is all around you.
Step out of limit zone,
and you are not alone.
Explore the world with
why heart,
why mind,
and
why vision.
Thanks for your attention.
The 22 队表演题目是 Global Vision Heart to Heart Connection， 计时开始。
We are the world，
沙拉。
We are the children，
沙拉拉拉。
We are the ones who make a brighter day， so let's start giving。There's a choice to make it， we're saving our own life。It's true, we'll make a better day.
Just you and me!
I don't know why, Mom. I have been feeling depressed.
This is so nice of you, Nini. Are you alright?
No. The lovely book with everything that nourishes my very mind suddenly became vapid.
Wow, you're poetic.
I'm serious. Don't you think I've been slightly too busy from tests at school?
Well, yes and no. As far as I can tell, the immense wealth of knowledge you have is quite satisfactory.
I'm not splitting hairs about who's right or wrong on this matter, but I'm afraid my zeal for learning will diminish shortly.
Snap out of it. I know you are the one who always knows how to cope with hardship in your life.
I long for a new way of learning.
You got mail.
Dear Mom and Dad, it's been so long since I left you. How have you been?
It's Patrick!
I think I made a brilliant choice for coming here. Everything just awesome. I never had such an enjoyable experience of taking classes that last for hours. They are working on 100 issues, such as cause of poverty, climate change, Syrian unrest, and so on. We really have a good time sharing our point of view. I was totally involved and realized that I am the one of the global citizens.
Well, workshop might be serious.
Egg. No, egg.
You are arranged to go on a local trip to a remote village of poverty to teach your kids English and play with them. We even prepare dinner for them by making some things from our own countries. They like it very much. I'm proud of that.
Wow, it's truly a feather in your cap, Patrick. Needless to say, I'm here for traveling too. We spent every afternoon and weekend on a city tour. We didn't simply go sightseeing. Instead, we had different tasks to accomplish. The tour is like a scavenger hunt. My group members and I try our best to communicate in English. Now, I find it natural to speak English.
Learning by doing sounds pretty efficient.
But here's the important thing. I'm afraid broke, Mom. Could you kindly help me out with this? I know I still have a 2 months left, but I know better that you always worry about me.
Patrick!
Love you.
Now I feel even worse.
Come on.
Summer, mystery, change your life. Dreamer, fulfill it, challenge your mind.
What's this?
Are you fed up with monotonous routines? Do you search for a whole new life?
P-P-A-P, I have a pen. I have an apple. Apple pen.
Haha, that's funny.
No, Mom, switch back.
We welcome the youth who always pursue a better life. With the world as a massive global village where people living across ocean can be nervous without distance. Check your needs. We provide many different programs that offer you great experience to heartily involve yourself with the land, the people, and the mass chill expo. Check it out!
Mom, this is it! Such good news and just in time. I gotta go for this one.
For what? Are you leaving us too?
Mom, you see, Patrick is happily learning abroad. I wanna have the same experience.
I worry not about you, but worry how I afford to send you too.
Hey, beautiful wife, I am way home. Anything all right?
Good news, I've gotten Patrick's mail that's saying he's enjoying himself there.
That's great. Anything else?
Yeah, your daughter said she wants to study abroad too after reading Patrick's mail, but I don't have the money for that.
Well, the trip is surely expensive, but the authentic experience of discovering the world is invaluable.
Dad, I love you.
Okay, you say so, then you pay more.
Why not?
But you should.
Hey, I'm driving. See you soon, honey.
Gary Roosevelt, well, in May, old time is still flying.
And let's stay explorer smile today. Tomorrow we'll be dying.
Then be not coy, but use your time. And while in May, go marry.
For having lost, but once your pride, you made for every Terry.
Thank you all.